This is therapeutic for us. So the fact that we have not been able to...
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is Friday night and we are live from the Funky Uncle Lounge. My name is Soul Stew and we have a one-of-a-kind performance coming up for you this fine, fine evening. Now, due to some unforeseen circumstances out of our control, Walter Wolfman Washington will not be able to join us this evening, but he says he's doing fine and he will be back soon. So sending our love out there to Walter. Sorry about that, but he'll be back. And don't worry, because tonight we've got one of the greatest to ever do it. This gorgeous, beautiful, magical woman that has been serenading us for all these years, the greatest to ever do it, Irma Thomas, is here at the Funky Uncle. Warms our heart to be in her presence, and that's just before she even steps up to the microphone. So it's going to be a wonderful evening. We are so honored to have her here, and so honored to all of you who have been tuned in. This is our one-year anniversary. A year ago today, we came into this float den to bring you a live show. We thought 3 months later we'd all be back to work and the world would be back to normal. It didn't go that way, but it's all right. We're still bringing the music to you, and we're helping our musicians and gig workers along the way. Leslie Cooper is going to tell you some more about how you can help become part of the Funky Uncle family. Good to see you, darling.
Happy anniversary.
Cheers. Happy 1 year.
This is celebrating our 1 year anniversary, and it's so easy to help. You can text FUNK to 36413. Or you can go to thefunkyuncle.live and click on the donate buttons there, and we're going to remind you of that. It's also going across the screen right now. I want to introduce to you or tell you about Frenchie, who is here. He paints a live Frenchie event painting each and every week. Frenchie, there he is. I was wondering where you are. Frenchie right there. Frenchie starts with a blank canvas, and I'm one of the luckiest women in town because I get to sit and watch it just magically
come to life.
It just it evolve, and it is absolutely incredible. I want to let you know that if you don't happen to be the lucky one that wins the bid, we have prints of Frenchie's paintings available on our website. That's right. You can go to the Frenchie printing at the prints on our merch, our funky shop. There's so much that you can find on our website, and I know that you'll find something you want. I know you will. Another way to help us. Another way is I want to thank our sponsors. We have the Edwards Mortgage Group, the NOLA Title Group, Mason Collective, and ARC Insurance Consultants. All your home needs for mortgage, closing, sales, and insurance. And this week, we've added another. We have Big Wave Media.
All right.
It's going to be very, very exciting. I want you to text FUNK to 36413 while Stu tells you what else you need to do.
All right, y'all. Give it up out there in the digital world for the greatest to ever do it. Soul Queen of New Orleans herself, the beautiful Irma Thomas. And don't forget to wash your hands and stomp your feet.
Our day will come when we'll have everything. We'll share the joy. Falling in love can bring. No one can tell me that I'm too young to know. I love
thank you.
we just wait a while? No tears for us. We'll love and wear a smile. Our dreams have magic because we'll always stay in love this way. Our day will come. Yep. If given enough time. For me too much. Yeah. Ooh. smoky windows. You can blame me, try to shame me, and still I'll care for you. You can run around, even put me down, still I'll be there.
All right, y'all. Give it up for the soul queen of New Orleans herself, the great Irma Thomas. To strip down her in a piano doesn't get more soulful than that. So happy to have her here. Of course, Irma's just renowned all over the world and has inspired so many musicians from the Beatles and the Rolling Stones to everyone who's come out of New Orleans and beyond. But I feel like there's nothing like seeing her perform in her hometown. And as much as everyone loves her, I don't feel like anyone could love her more than we do here in New Orleans. Such an honor to have her here. And we can't think of a better way to celebrate 1 year of the Funky Uncle than by having her come in here. And in that 1 year's time, we've been able to help a lot of people. Our musicians and gig workers, we've raised over $300,000. We've helped over 400 people, and it warms my heart to be able to tell you that. We couldn't have done it without your support. And there's just nothing like, for me, calling up a musician or a gig worker, someone who I've just seen work so hard for so many years, and say, hey, do you need some help? We're here. Just come to me. I got you. And then they call me up, you know, a week later, just pouring their hearts out. They said, listen, you really helped us out. Thank you. And, you know, it means a lot. We couldn't do that without you. Couldn't do that without our sponsors either. And that's, you know, why we're here. And that's why these musicians keep on coming in and sharing their music with us, because they know it goes right back to our community. My dear friend, Miss Leslie Cooper, is going to talk to you some more about how you can help join the Funky Uncle family, help our local music community.
I am going to do that, but first, we could not do this without our production crew.
Amen.
And
to
our
that.
Producers. And one of our producers, come here, Christian. Christian.
Happy birthday.
We are, no, we've got a real professional to sing.
Yeah, I was going to say, what are you?
I was
going to
say, Stu. All right, Christian, this is your birthday, and we are so happy that we are able to celebrate it with you. And I'm jealous because that lady gets to sing to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Christian. Happy birthday to you.
Don't blow your candles out.
Love
you,
brother.
Thank you, Irma. Yeah, you can't blow those out. Well, he could. Then he gets to eat the whole cake. All right. And speaking of the whole cake, you can feel like it's your birthday if you go to the website and you go to the button that says bid on the Frenchie painting. If you've ever seen a Frenchie, then you know how, oh gosh, how incredible they are. Every time I look at it, I feel like I can hear the music that was being played that night. I know that I am going to remember that night fondly. And you can bid on this painting. Now, the starting bid is $5,000. And for those of you who know about Frenchies, you know that it is that's a steal. That's just the opening bid, okay? That's just the opening bid. And what we are doing tonight is we're going to give you sneak peeks all the way through this, all right? Every break that we take. So go to that bid on the Frenchie painting, and it's a $5,000 minimum. This is how we raise money to help all of our musicians. Now, we have two other Frenchies originals that haven't sold yet, and they are on the screen. I believe they are, I believe that one is, there's Glenn David Andrews. That one is still available. And again, you can go to, oh, there's Kirk Joseph. That one was,
yeah.
Those are the only two that have not sold as of yet.
Out of 50, right?
Out of 52 of them, that's right. And of course, there are the prints again. So don't forget that. While you're there on that website, you go to the Funky Shop, and there's all of our apparel. There's T-shirts and masks and all kind of good stuff.
Swagged out.
So many swag. So many different ways that you can help us with the apparel that we have on the Funk Shop, the Funky Shop. Excuse me. All right. So there's all different ways. I've told you all about them. Please support us. Click on that donate button. Text FUNK to 36413 while you are looking at all of these great things that you can do to help support our musicians. It's just that simple. They need our help. There is light at the end of the tunnel, but we are still in that tunnel, aren't we? I'm so glad that so many of our musicians today, I got to give props to the New Orleans Musicians Clinic. They second vaccines of 239 musicians and culture bearers today alone. So we're getting closer to where we can all be together. I love you, Stu, but I want to sit next to some other people sometimes, you know?
I hear you. Fair enough.
All right. Fair enough. Does that work for you?
Especially if we're in like a club with a band in front of us. Wouldn't that be nice?
Good. Although I think we got it pretty sweet right here. And if you're at home on your sofa, you've got it sweet because you've got Miss Irma Thomas singing to you while you text FUNK to 36413.
All right, y'all, we're going to let the Soul Queen get back to doing what she does so beautifully. So in the meantime, y'all don't forget to wash your hands and stomp your feet. Take care,
Irma. While you're washing your hands and stomping your feet, we're going to get a friend of mine who's been around since mud like me. We're going to get Leo to come up here and do a few songs. Leo Nocentelli. We haven't lost it yet, Leo. We still got it. We don't know what it is we got,
yeah,
but we still got it. Yeah. It's interesting that we still have to ask the world to participate and help musicians whenever they are down and out, they always ask us to help them. But
here's a time that we need them to help us, the musicians and of the city of New Orleans, and not just in the city of New Orleans, but the state of Louisiana. They all need help. When everybody was out getting their little unemployment checks, those guys didn't get unemployment checks because they don't work that way. We work from gig to gig, and those of us who do file unemployment can't get it anyway, because when I tried, they told me I had to go back 7 years to prove I work. Come on now, I've been in the business 60 years. You got to prove to you I work? Come on now. So I said, you know, you keep it. I'll be all right. I'm blessed to have a good husband manager.
Yes, indeed.
So he prepared for days like this. You ready, Leo? Just about? Huh? We're going to do Rule of My Heart. Anybody out there celebrating anniversaries? This is a good song for them. Yes, indeed. Here's the New Orleans National Anthem. It's raining so hard, look like it's gonna rain all night. And this is the time I'd love to be holding.
from my window, watching the rain fall to the ground. This is the time. Guess I'll just go crazy tonight.
Play one. Twist on that, huh? Well, here's one for you. You could have my husband, but please don't mess with my man. Yes, he's mine. don't mess with it. Leave me alone. You still got it, kids. You still got it.
Thank you, guys. Ms. Irma Thomas.
Yes, all right.
Yeah, you're right, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up. Leo Nocentelli with the great Irma Thomas. Now, that is something you don't get to see every day, even in New Orleans, these two getting to share the stage together. Two New Orleans legends with so many decades of incredible music history in this town. What an honor to have them in here. And we're all doing it for a great cause. My man Frenchie is right next to me, and he is immortalizing this on the canvas in his unique style. He's already got the figures outlined on here. It's looking good. And I'm just telling you, the joy and the soul Frenchie puts in these paintings is just like no other. And when you have one in your home, you woke up, you could just feel the music radiating off of them. Frenchie, where you at, bro? Come say hi to the people, man. What a beautiful night. You having fun?
I'm feeling truly blessed to be here tonight with y'all. Irma, Leo, you guys. Yeah, you're right.
Amen to that, bro. I know you pour your heart and soul into these paintings, and it shows. It definitely shows. And if you're liking that, you can, congratulations, you can have a Frenchie. You can have a Frenchie original. We've got two behind us, and we've got this one in the works. I'm not sure if it's sold just yet. I know some people are pretty interested, so you might want to jump on that.
Still being
bid on right now. And then we've got these two beautiful ones here behind us. Leslie could tell you something about how you can help us, you know, send you some art and swag you out and join the Funky Uncle family.
Absolutely. You can go to the website, thefunkyuncle.live, and after you click on the donate button, I want you to look at the our section on Frenchie. There's some history, there's a little bit of a bio, and there's all the Frenchie paintings that he has done. You can find the prints under the Funky Shop. The Frenchie paintings have raised over $100,000. Absolutely.
Yeah,
and yes, you know, we, in 53 weeks, in 53 weeks, guess what we have raised? We have raised $312,102.65. I forgot about that. I got to do the 65 cents. We have helped 453 musicians and gig workers, and so much of that has been because of these Frenchie paintings. These two back here behind me, you can still own those. That's right. You can reach out to us, and we will talk about that. I'm not going to say we will make you a deal. We will discuss how you can pay us for that, because that's really, I'm making a joke about it, but that is what, that goes to be such a large amount that we make each week. And every time one of these paintings goes out the door, I know that we are able to help more musicians and more gig workers. It's been so tough on them, and I really, really want to ask you for your support. If you have a business that you think will be that will benefit from reaching our huge audience each week, then click on that sponsor button. Please click on that sponsor button. We have the Edwards Mortgage Group, NOLA Title Group, the Mason Collective, and ARC Insurance Consultants. All your home needs for mortgage, sales, closing, and insurance. You want a new house? Call these folks up, all right? And then we one-stop shopping.
You can put your Frenchies in your new house.
You can put your Frenchie in your new house. That's right. And this week we are joined by a wonderful lady and her group, Big Wave Media. And we'll talk a little bit more about that later. All right? If you want to do the quick and easy, the down and dirty, text FUNK to 36413. I don't know about you, but I'm ready for some more music.
I am too. Let's let the lovely Miss Irma get back to it, y'all. In the meantime, don't forget to wash your hands, stomp your feet.
This song was written by Warner, his brother, and another musician that works with us. And it's a song that I call a commitment song. The way we want you to commit to helping the musicians, we also want you to commit to each other. You say you want me. You say you need me. But are you willing to pay the price? You claim you love me, always thinking of me. Then make me your wife, 'cause I want you. For the rest of my life. Yes, I do. You say you feel me. Can't wait to see me. That we're on our way, 'cause I love you. For the rest of my life. Yes, I will. For the rest of my life. One of those songs that you don't have to think. It's telling you exactly what's there to believe. You're gonna have tough times, but it's called communication. And we definitely want you to communicate tonight and pick up the phone and pull out your plastic money and bid. Nobody carries cash anymore. They call it plastic money. Ready? Yes, this is another one of those love songs. Yeah, well, you know, we need to spread a little bit more love nowadays. It's so much other stuff going on, so I want to remind folks that deep down inside, you really do love one another. You've just forgotten how to show it. I went to sleep smiling when you left. I opened my eyes. I must have been dreaming. You took me by surprise. Man can change his ways if he wants to. Can a woman change her mind? Even now, I still love you. Sometimes I wonder how. But I'm wishing you only the best. Yes, I guess we're even now. Suspicion. We took them all too far. All the wrong decisions have invaded star by star. You say there's no use trying. Turning stones you can't find. Even now, I still love you. Sometimes, I wonder how. I guess Yeah. Here's a song. I don't think it's been 100 years since we did this one. How one is called Trying to Catch a Cab in the Rain. Although now they don't call them cabs anymore, they call them Ubers. Yeah, I have my cheat iPad here, so it's been a while. And when you've been doing songs as long as I have, you don't remember everything you've ever recorded. And I don't even try anymore, especially when I got my cheat iPad here. Keep playing, Warner. I'm soaked clear through. I've been waving at the passing cars. They're going by just like shooting stars. I'd like to be with you wherever you are right now. Trying to catch a cab in the rain. It's like trying to flag down a train. Trying to catch a cab in the rain. It's a losing game. I'm stranded in no man's land, where the bus don't run and the trains don't go. Won't you stop for me? There's some place I've got to be, and somebody I'd love to see right now. Trying to catch a cab in the rain. It's like trying to flag down a train. I'm trying to catch a cab in the rain. It's a losing game. Up and down Broadway, I'm walking around, talking to myself. Could it be right, or could it be left, or could it be left? Streetlights are out, and I'm still stumbling around. This town. Woo. 'Cause I'm trying to catch a cab in the rain. It's like trying to flag down a train. Trying to catch a cab in the rain. It's a losing game. Trying to catch a cab in the rain. It's like trying to flag down a train. I'm trying to catch a cab in the rain. It's a losing game.
Woo.
All right, y'all. The wonderful soul queen of New Orleans herself, Irma Thomas, here at the Funky Uncle. And I got to give a big shout out to the great Warner Williams on the piano there, making it all sound so lovely.
Yes, indeed.
I love it. It's stripped down and just the raw soul. And it sounds so sweet to my ears. And I'm so honored to have these fine musicians here with us. Of course, big shout out to Leo Nocentelli for sitting in. That was fantastic. My man, Frenchie, is sitting right next to me. He's got a beautiful painting going on. Now the colors, he had the outline last time we checked in with him. Now he's got the colors flowing and it's all really coming together. You can see the musicians' faces. You can see just the soul oozing out while they're, you know, performing. And it's beautiful. This is something that I'm sure many people are going to want in their hands. So in their hands, in their walls, on their walls, all that good stuff. So you can take it home if you're lucky enough. Let's
minimum
tell
bid.
You some more about that.
That minimum bid.
Five big ones, right?
Five big ones. And you know that it's worth every bit
Which
of that.
Which is a typical Frenchie.
Absolutely go, worth every bit of that.
Every bit.
And if you can't get the Frenchie original, we have prints of each and every one of the shows. They say that if I'm a really good girl for Mother's Day, birthday, Christmas, anniversary, all rolled up into one, I get to pick like four or five of them. My family said they'd go in on it, but I can't do that. I want them
so
all.
Hard.
I do. And I want you to want them all. You just go to that Frenchie, bid on the Frenchie painting, and bid on that right now. I want you to text Funk to 36413 because you know we got that on there. You can become a Funky Cousin. And then I want you to go to the Funky Shop and check out our apparel. Now, last week was our 52nd week, all right, for 52 weeks. And I told you that if you donated $52, that I would send you a deck of 52 cards. And they just showed you those cards on there. Oh, there they are again. Show us that.
So
aren't
cool.
Aren't those great? God,
they've
awesome. Got all of the amazing musicians on each one of those cards. So I'm gonna let us roll with that one more time, one more week, so that you can get caught up into that in that one, okay? Become a Funky Cousin by becoming a recurring member. That's right. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to remember. Just each week it comes out. And if you donate $100 recurring once a month, we will give you one of these Frenchie prints. Not an original, but one of the prints. And
still
I think
awesome.
That's a pretty good. Yeah. I think that's a pretty good deal,
I mean,
if you
gorgeous.
Ask me there.
He prints them on the canvas. I mean,
Frenchie is going to give a. Oh, Frenchie.
Nice.
Miss Irma, guess what? You're getting, Frenchie is going to give you a print of this one that he's painting for you tonight.
Yes.
And it's embellished, which means he'll actually sign it and sparkle it.
Yeah.
And there might be some
touch
glitter
it up
on
for
it
you.
And touch it up for you. It's going to be a really wonderful thing. Those are our ways to sponsor. I mean, to donate. You can become a sponsor. And I do have to take a moment to mention something from the Funky Uncle family. We are sending our love and our light to Jason and Lorette Neville. Tristan left us entirely too early, and our hearts go out to you. You're part of our family, and we are here for you. And we hope to see you soon where we can give you big hugs in person, all right? So become part of our family. It's a good family. We take care of our own. We take care of our musicians and our gig workers. And we hope that you will become a part of that family as well. Text Funk to 36413 and help us make that happen.
All right, Miss Sermon, you have another one for us? You got two more? All right, wonderful. We're going to let them go back to it.
I came into this smoke-filled room. Suddenly I was face to face with you. I felt a flood of emotion, like a wave that rolled on through. It took me back to yesterday, when love was all I had for you. It was good enough, I thought. Just like the rain from a stormy sky. But I ain't crying over you. These are tears from a smoke-filled room. I walked across that smoke-filled room, locked in another girl's embrace. I can see the way she looks at you. I know the feeling. I used to be in her place. So go on, caress her fingertips. I'm tough, I can stand the pain. But baby, if you see me choking, it's not from some old flame. It's a smoke-filled room that burns my eyes. It's like the rain from a stormy sky.
This next song is a song I'd like to dedicate to all of my fellow musicians, mainly because some of us have been doing this for a very long time, and we thank all of our fans for hanging in there with us, coming to see us, and then sharing our moments of joy and sadness whenever there is. But now we want you to share the happiness. We want you to share the happiness that we are able to start back to performing in some way or another, bringing joy to the people that we love bringing joy to, yes. And it's things like this, performing and bringing joy to others, that we love to do. And so I want all you guys out there, all my fellow musicians, to keep in mind that as long as we can do what we love, we will always stay forever young. Good Lord bless and keep you. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars, climb on every rung. May you stay forever young. May you grow up to be righteous. May you grow up to be true. May you always look for others and always surrounding you. May you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong. May you stay forever young. May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of change are shift. May you always be joyful. May you always be strong. May you stay forever young. Forever young. Forever young. May you stay. May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of change are shift. May you always be joyful. May your song always be sung. May you stay.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the soul queen of New Orleans, Irma Thomas, Warner Williams on the piano, Leo Nocentelli sitting on the guitar. We are, we're having to dry our eyes over here at the Funky Uncle after that one.
Irma, this is the first time that I've had a handkerchief that got soggy before I waved it in the air at one of your concerts. Right. Oh, my goodness. This MC.
Thanks so much to Irma and Warner for coming out here. Now, Frenchie's been pouring his heart into this beautiful original painting, just the same way the musicians give it their heart and soul. He does the same thing on his canvas. It's looking beautiful. He might, you know, twerk it some more, but it can be yours, and it will remind you of a wonderful night of music that happened here in the Crescent City. So, how about this, Leslie?
Can I
this
sell a
incredible.
Kidney and buy it? Because I want, right? I want it now. I do. Frenchie, I want to thank you. Where is Frenchie? I can't see. Is where did he go?
Oh,
he's off in the corner crying like I was.
Yeah.
Wow. I tell you what, that was amazing. When's the, do you remember the first time do you remember the first time you saw Irma?
I remember one of them. I was wandering through Jazz Fest, and I heard something beautiful coming from the gospel tent. I went, and Urban was up there in this beautiful, flowing, like, white dress robe, and the fans were on her, and it was kind of flowing in the breeze, and it seemed like the whole gospel tent was just hovering on a cloud above Jazz Fest, and we were all just looking down. It was so beautiful, and I'll remember that to this day. And of all the Jazz Fest memories, that one forever
that
will
one
stand
sticks
out.
With you.
And then, of course, at WWZ when she would come in for Fun Drive, and I'd have the pleasure of sitting down with her with a friend, George Ingmar. But
so
always such an honor.
This is the Fridays from the Funky Uncle is an amazing thing because this is where we are raising money, but we get to have these magical moments like this, and we are going to bring these to you until you can be out there and remembering those magical moments yourself. Now, we can only do that, though, if you help us out, and I would really, really appreciate it if you would text FUNK to 36413, donate, or go to the website, thefunkyuncle.live. And
Leo in the house.
I was just fixing to
the
say,
funk master.
We have a repeat offender here.
Yeah, we
and
do.
That is Leo, who, hey, let's see, we did New Year's Eve and we did George
and
George Leo.
George together.
And now here you are, you know, after three times, we got to dance. You know, we met each other three times, now we got to dance. We'll do that, all right, with your lovely, wait, I know who I want you to dance with, but it may not be me. But anyway, I want to thank them for being here because that was incredible. That's not something you're going to see on a Saturday afternoon, a Saturday night in one of your clubs. It really isn't. It's not. That's what makes Funky Uncle so special, and we want you to be a part of it. Text FUNK 36413, go to the website, thefunkyuncle.live, bid on this Frenchie painting. Can anybody in the office tell me how much where we're up to yet? That starting bid was at 5, so I'll find that out. We want to thank our sponsors.
Absolutely. Edwards Mortgage Group, NOLA Title Group, the Maison Collective, and ARC Insurance Consultants, and of course our good friends over at Big Wave Media for all they've done for us as well. And if you want to go relive this magical night and many of the other ones that we've brought to you, you can go to our website, thefunkyuncle.live, and go through our archive and relive all these wonderful nights of music. And I'm telling you, I might, as soon as I get home, I just might go rewatch this
watch
movie.
You can watch
it. Crying my eyes out again.
And our upcoming show, guess what we've got next week?
Mark Mullins.
Bone in the house. Mark Mullins next week. So please, please consider becoming one of our cousins and helping us out. I'm going to sit down with Miss Irma. And
this
one's going to be good.
Those of y'all out there in the digital world, Leslie and Irma have known each other for probably as long as I've been alive, maybe even longer. Not to date you, but they go way back. And she's got some amazing stories with Irma.
It's one
y'all
Mardi Gras day. I'm hoping she remembers because I will never forget.
Amen to that.
Thank you so much for tuning in. Stick around. We are going to be back in just a few minutes with an amazing interview. And in the meantime,
don't forget to wash your hands and stomp your feet. Yeah. All right, you know, who that?
Sure, we put on a lot of really great concerts here, live from the Funky Uncle on Friday nights. But what's it really all about?
Love. Appreciation, you know, just trying to give back
anymore.
Being able to actually come in here
and see a great band and get to interview them that just did so much for my soul. But honestly, just the way we've been able to help people too. Not only to book a band and say, hey, we've got a paid gig for you during COVID, but then also just to be able to call up someone I love, like Johnny Vodakovich, who's brought me so much joy, and say, listen, man, I know it's a tough time. Guess what? I got a check for you tomorrow. I'm bringing it by your house. You don't even have to come outside. I'll put it under the door.
And I really can't, I don't even know how to say a big enough thank you.
Oh, man, you just keep being you, brother. That's all. That's all we ask. Right? I mean, this whole thing that we're going through, it's just a different break in the rhythm, right? You know?
Tick-tock, tick-tock.
One long pause.
You know, and you got to give unconditionally without ever expecting anything in return. Otherwise, you don't learn, you know?
And they say, well, here's the such and such, you know, some money to help you out, you know? And I couldn't believe it. I said, whoa, all right, well, great. And so that's how I first found out about the Funky Uncle. Yeah, he gave me money on the spot, you know, which I thought was nominated. You know, I never really got any assistance from nothing to the COVID. I don't know if I really applied for anything either. You know, so he gave me like $400 on the spot, and I said, wow. Well, thank you, Chris. And it's a great thing that they're doing that, because I'm quite sure there's a lot of musicians that are in need for a lot of things right now. And but it helped me immensely. It helped me at a time when I really needed help.
We don't just do our art just for us. We do our art, you know, just for you. We do our art for us as well. And this is therapeutic for us. So the fact that we have not been able to get together and jam out and do what we love to do the last 2 months, a month and a half.
I mean, we were playing
the day before
three or four nights a week. You know, so we were seeing each other every day.
I just like went through withdrawal, like cold turkey. I just put the last cigarette down and I have not picked it back up. So my nerves is bad and I'm super, super excited to hit this cigarette right now.
We come to see the music and we come to enjoy the music here, but it's so many more people it takes to bring the music. And by walking in the door here and seeing all the other people, it just made sense to me that more money needed to go to the gig work.
Yeah, the Funky Uncle Dot Live, man, they're helping a lot of people. I really love what they're doing. It's great, man. They've helped me, man. I was actually behind on a lot of my bills coming up because of the pandemic. I was behind on my my car insurance and my car note and stuff like that, rent and, you know, things of that nature. And they've stepped in and helped me, man.
This is the worst I've ever seen it for entertainers and people that assist the entertainers, like you said, the gig workers, and you know, the guys and gals who work backstage. They don't have any work either. So it's this I've never seen it this bad.
It's the big, giant, invisible hurricane that we can't evacuate away from.
No.
It really is not.
Coronavirus, no more gigs. So now we're here at the Funky Uncle.
Don't call you. That's my landlord. He's doing a thing.
Yeah, I'm going to call him too, but tell him to call me up and we'll get the communication going.
That's Mark. Don't forget. No.
Yeah, we'll get it straight. Don't worry. We ain't going to forget you.
To make a living right now, basically. I'm not getting any money, enough money, you know, from the government to even mention. I mean, it's not paying all my bills. It's not paying none of my bills. I'm basically just making it off the street right now, you know, just playing on the street.
You know, this is just as good of medicine for me as it is for the ones we're helping. Christian called, and I'm like, yeah, man, yeah, I'll come paint. And he's like, oh, no, that's not what I was calling for, French. I just wanted to use your float for the background shot. And I'm like, oh, but it's cool if I come paint, right?
My favorite part about doing this thing at the Funky Uncle is that a lot of, you know, when bands come in, this is the first time they've played together in a while, and it's just like a certain fire that comes back. Like, so you can feel everyone, you know, it feels good to be back together. So it seems like y'all were really, you know.
Yeah, he's ready.
For solidifying that tonight.
Hey, you got to get it in, man.
You were, know, exactly. It felt like we were just in a packed, sold-out club.
Exactly. Now, look, a lot of people don't know. It's weird, though. You know, like, you're pouring, you know, your heart and soul out. Oh, but it's weird, man, because nobody's there. It's like, it's just the camera. So you're just looking like,
and our crew just like, yeah, right.
When I find out about the assistance that Fridays from the Funky Uncle gives to musicians and gig workers, I thought that was really an incredible thing.
I came home one night and I found my oak tree here had dropped a limb that was so big that I couldn't even reach around it. And it destroyed my neighbor's fence and into her backyard. So that put the dental surgery on hold. And then someone said, well, wait, how about that funky uncle thing? Don't they give assistance? I mentioned it to somebody, and within 2 days, they said, this is exactly what we're trying to do. We're trying to help our folks. And I became a very proud recipient of assistance from the Funky Uncle.
And we're proud to be a part of this community. You know, this isn't the first time something like this has happened. Our right. fellow musicians, you know, they may start a fund. You know, if somebody, we try to make sure that we help each other.
Absolutely.
And we're a community of band members, we're a community of musicians, and we are a community of people here. You know, we see things happening around the city, around the world. I have to be true to my own experience. I love my city. I roll with my city.
That little pump through loud and clear.
Yo, me and Willie Green, just let you know, Fridays from the Funky Uncles, we want you to be down there and kick ass with the Funky Uncles, yo. Yo, baby.
The Funky Uncle has really, like, I've seen it help a lot of musicians, including myself, like, just in the nick of time. Like, having groups to come together to really take care of the artists that kind of make sure New Orleans is what it is, like, has been really helpful.
When you talk about lights, camera, action, there's like no gigs, no festivals, there's, you know, instability everywhere. There's one thing that we can control as a musician. Play your music as best you can.
And when you have programs like this.
Absolutely.
The Fridays from the Funky Uncle that have pulled together to not take care of just you guys.
It takes a village to play music.
It does. It does. Our stage hands, our lighting techs, our video techs, our sound guys.
I'm a musician. I got to find a way to play. And if there's no other avenues for me to play, I'm going to create them. But it just allows me, the bottom line, to write a song, perform a song, touch somebody, bring people together.
So you enjoy coming to the shows? And
oh, definitely, us? Definitely. Music's our lifeblood. And I was getting pretty antsy before that. we live for our music, and not having it for such a long time was tough. It really was.
And really, these people are gems. They're living legends who get really no support any time of the year. So right now, with COVID the way it is, a lot of these people are really, really struggling. So we're really trying to reach out to the streets, find these guys in their natural habitat, and help them out, because somebody's got to.
It's a massive honor to be part of making magic music medicine out of New Orleans for the universe.
Absolutely.
You got to give without expecting anything in return. And that's what's happening. And you know, New Orleans, the importance of the New Orleans music putting out the love and the light, it goes back to Louis Armstrong after World War II, and they sent him all around the world to introduce jazz to everybody. You know, I mean, in a way, I feel we're doing that here in the Den in a spiritual way every Friday. And without having to leave the country, we're putting out that magic music medicine.
It may not be some groundbreaking amount that you can retire on, but you know, a little bit of help goes a long way in these times.
Hi, I'm Leslie Cooper, and I'm here. My favorite part of Fridays from the Funky Uncle is when I get to interview our musicians. And tonight, I am interviewing one of my favorite people in the entire world, Miss Irma Thomas. Thank you so much for being here. I really, really appreciate it.
My pleasure.
You have been instrumental here recently in helping musicians with a message that I saw on the Jazz and Heritage website. Can mm-hmm. you tell us a little bit about that program and what they're doing?
Well, I go way back with the musician situation. It started out when we were losing musicians from illnesses that could have been helped if they had doctor's care. So I started out helping the musicians' clinic, and that worked out where we had to get all the guys to let them know that there's somewhere for them to go and get treated. And then with the situation being now with the COVID thing, they decided that they were going to get someone to help the musicians, you know, get through these rough periods. And so that's what that you asked me about. That's what that was all about, help letting people know that we as musicians have been helping you guys when you had hard times. Now it's time for you to turn the favor back and help the musicians. Because like I said, musicians, most of them work from paycheck to paycheck and are not able or not qualified to get unemployment. So that's what that program is all about, to help musicians get through the rough spots. Some may have house notes or rents or car notes or whatever situation may be. They're there to help them fill that gap so they won't fall behind in whatever it is they're trying to do.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much, because they all need help. We all need help.
We all need help. You know, the thing of it is with us musicians, we're always willing to give. And even some of in the funniest thing, it reminds me of the time when Katrina happened, all of those that they could find, we went to New York, and it was from the Big Apple to the Big Easy. Mm-hmm. And all of us who was on that stage, all of us had lost everything we had. You know, so this is another situation where most of the musicians that during this pandemic thing lost all of their work. Mm-hmm. So now we're asking the general public to step up to the plate and do what you can to help them.
I mentioned in one of our earlier shows that this seemed like, when it first happened, it seemed like a big, giant, invisible hurricane that was coming at us, mm-hmm. but we had nowhere to evacuate to.
No.
Because it was everywhere.
It was everywhere.
And our musicians were the first ones fired and now the last ones hired. And
of
our
course.
Gig workers. we don't have conventions coming to town. They don't need lights. They don't need audio, whatever. Mm-hmm. And they want you to come and sing on their front porch.
I've done that a few times.
And But it's just not the same. And until we can get back to it. And things, after Katrina, we got a new normal. We have a new normal.
Well, this is going to be the new normal for mm-hmm. quite some time. And the irony of it is, with when it comes to hiring musicians, for some reason, they always feel that musicians shouldn't make the money that they feel that they make. They always want you to give them a deal. Well, we don't live off of deals. We can't pay bills on deals.
No.
Pay the musicians what they feel that they are worth. And if you know it's really an insult to tell, the minute you hire a musician, you want to tell them what your budget is. They got budgets too.
Yeah, yeah.
So you know, help them meet their budget, and maybe you make your budget.
That's right. That's right. I asked a doctor once. My kid needs his tonsils out. Can I get a 2-for-1?
Please.
You know, you wanted me to play. You wanted us to play half price. Can I get a half price tonsils? He didn't like that.
But. Of course not. Of course not. But so, in all, I really am pleased to know that these gigs that you're doing right now are going to help the musicians, and I hope that you know they're able to help everyone who in need of it.
I am very happy with what we've been able to do here, and we're changing lives every day in the people who have changed our lives. Mm-hmm. You've changed my life many, many years ago. As a younger jazz musician, my band broke up, my parents quit playing, and I started to learn your tunes.
Sure.
And I sat in, it's like, oh, I'll do Irma tunes now. And I would sit in the carpool line singing to the top of my lungs, you know, hip shaking mama, and they were concerned about putting my kids in my car with me when I'd pull up. You okay, Leslie? All right. And one magical Mardi Gras day, I was working at the Toulouse Theater, and it was BBC to the World. And I was working hospitality with Gloria Powers. and I'm out on the balcony just hanging out, minding my own business, and you walk out with a box of fried chicken. And you were like, this chicken is cold. And I said, I know, Miss Irma, it got here at 7 o'clock this morning. I'm so sorry. And I watched you walk to the edge of the balcony to the house next to the building next door. And they were all on their balcony. And you said, excuse me, do you have an oven? And I'm like, what is she doing? This chicken's cold. And they took that box
and
of chicken.
The chicken.
And
yeah.
they warmed it up for
all you.
All
you have to do is ask.
Hot chicken on a Mardi Gras day. And you and I sat and just visited. Yeah. And I remember thinking, I'm talking to Irma. Oh, my God, I'm talking to Irma. I've had the pleasure of spending other festivals with yeah. you. Mm-hmm. When I was pregnant, you came and comforted me. Mm-hmm. I wasn't feeling too good that day in Natchez, and mm-hmm. that sticks with me. The work that you do with WWOZ during every
oh, yeah.
pledge drive.
Oh, yeah.
You are truly a queen. And how did you get, do you remember who gave you that title?
Yes, I can tell you exactly who gave me that title. Some years ago, when I got back from California, you know, I lived in California for a few years.
We'll forgive you.
My husband and I got together, and we got my own backup group. We call them the Professionals. And the drummer at that time, his name was Wilbert Widow. Mm-hmm. His son, both of his sons are now high school music teachers at various highs. In fact, one of them is at O'Perry Walker Landry. Mr. Rollins.
Mr. Rollins.
His
yes.
dad. His dad started working for me when they were in grammar school, and his dad worked with me for 27 years.
Wow.
So he didn't want to call me the singing grandma.
No.
So he decided to call me the soul queen of New Orleans.
That's a good thing.
And then in 1989, I think it was Kalamo Yasalam. I think that's how he pronounces his name. He decided to make it official, and then on the Singer Theater stage in February 17th, I know it exactly because it was the day before my birthday, they crowned me officially the Soul Queen of New Orleans. But Sir Wilbert Willard, because I gave him a sir since he called me the queen, he worked with me for 27 years. In fact, he worked wow. with me up until the week before he passed away.
Wow.
But he gave me that name, the Soul Queen of New Orleans.
And you are.
And it stuck.
And it stuck. What do you feel is your most meaningful acknowledgement or award in the music industry?
Well, I have to say that all entertainers who are in the music business, they want to win a Grammy. And I was blessed. I finally won one after 3 nominations. But aside from that, I've gotten awarded, I'm Dr. Irma, you know.
I was there that day at Loyola and got to sit behind you and listen to you sing.
It's strange that they call me Dr. Irma because I'm always giving out advice to people.
We're going to start you a radio show. All right? I got this thing.
But
on
it's just this thing that, you know, I'm a people person. I'm an only child. Folks don't realize that. And I grew up among a lot of cousins. So I've always had to fight for myself and always had to speak up for myself. But I've always felt that if I could give someone something that's going to help them, I would rather give them the benefit of my experience. And whenever I walk, like I did with you when you were pregnant, I told you, don't worry about it in the whole 9 yards. I ain't explain all that to you. Well, that's just a habit with me. And my husband said, I'm glad I'm your husband. He said, because if it wouldn't be for me, we'd be broke because I'd give away everything. But I enjoy being able to help someone. If they ask me and they want me to give them my honest opinion, then I will give them my honest opinion. Mm-hmm. Other than that, I'm just Irma. I don't know no other way to be.
And that's what is so special.
You know, the thing
you.
About it, if you come to one of my shows and I'm able to do it and I have the time, if you can't sing it, it won't be on me. Because if you want to sing, I'll let you get up there and sing. You know, I've had that to happen. People tell me to get up. I want to do a song. I said, can you sing? Yeah, I can sing.
It is on tape. I did. Christian talked me into doing Hip Shaking Mama.
Well.
One night. We'll have to... You go look it up on the funkyuncle.live and then call me and tell me, okay, now first you need to do this.
Right. Well, you know, I when it comes to singing and performing, I don't tell people how to express a song. because that you are a storyteller. You're telling it your way. I mean, if you sung Hip Shaking Mama and you didn't do it the way I did it, that's nothing for me to get offended by. You're supposed to do it the way you feel it. You are a storyteller. You're just putting it to music. So no one should be criticizing the way you sing it. It may not sound, you don't want to sound like me. You want to sound like yourself. You want to sell what you feel, and that's what singing is about. I do other people's material. I did quite a bit of it tonight.
It was amazing.
And so I do how I feel, what I feel about the song, and I sing it the way I feel it. I stay within the charts, of course, you know, the changes and everything.
Right.
But the way I feel it is how I sing it. And if I can't feel the song, I won't sing it.
Forever Young, just it. You yeah. ripped my heart out and stomped on it.
Well, think
a
about
time
it.
Or two.
Think about how many folk who are still in this business who are past their 50s.
Mm-hmm.
And if we didn't think young, we wouldn't be able to do this.
You are timeless. You are certainly timeless. Happy late birthday,
thank
by
you.
The way.
Thank you.
Eric Paulson said to tell you hello.
I sung
to
his favorite
morning.
Song tonight.
Yeah, which
you
one
can
is
have
that?
My husband, but please don't mess up. Don't ask me why he likes that song.
Why does he like that?
I have no idea. He never tells me. He just always requests it.
Now, I will say, back in the 1980s, I found a 45 of that at Jim Russell's Rare Records.
How many thousands of dollars he charged you for it?
It had $2.50 on it, and when I went to ring it up,
uh-huh.
he almost had a hemorrhage. He followed me out the door. He was like, no, 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 that had the wrong price on it. That had the wrong price on it. I was like, too bad, bye,
did
got
I,
my car,
did,
and I was gone.
Did I read that one well?
Yes, you mm-hmm. did.
I know. You're not the first one who's gone there and purchased a 45 and spent a small fortune for
no,
it.
No, I managed to walk out the door with that one. But now, being a woman in music industry today, as compared to when it started, when you started, that you know those marimba players, they are everywhere, everywhere.
That's okay.
I'm
going to
ask you
it
that
happens.
One again.
That's okay.
Being a woman in the music industry, I know is different. But compared to when you first started, how do you feel that not only you but the other women that are out there making music today, are there challenges more, or do they have more challenges, less challenges? Is it easier for them?
It depends on what the challenge is. Musically, we've come a long way. There was a time that women were supposed to sing a certain way, act a certain way on stage, and I guess it was morally trying to keep us moral for whatever that was. But but we've come a long way. Women nowadays can play and sing just about any type of music they want mm-hmm. to, the way they want to do it. I've never seen so many female guitar players in my life in the last 20 years.
No.
I think they're everywhere. But that's a good thing, because most of them can mm-hmm. play very well. Because before, it wasn't ladylike to be a guitarist.
Yeah.
You know, so now they put that aside. It's not the fact that you're a lady, the fact that you're a musician, and we're gaining that respect as a musician.
Excellent.
The only thing I regret is that I never really learned to play piano very well. I can mm-hmm. plunk out things, but I'm not proficient at it. But nevertheless, I'm glad to see now that female musicians are being respected as musicians, because it doesn't have anything to do with what you are, male or female. It's the musicianship that's mm-hmm. important.
I'm glad to know that you recognize that too. And there have been a lot of programs, Girls with Guitars.
Mm-hmm.
I think they started about 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And if they were 15, you know, 12, 13, 14, 15 years
mm-hmm.
old,
mm-hmm.
they're young women in the business now. Mm-hmm. And I'm really happy, mm-hmm. happy to see
they
that.
Would always try to make have the young women when they want to play a guitar or a saxophone or a trumpet. No, you should play piano. Why?
Flute.
If that's not what they want to play, you know, yeah, or a flute, yeah. But now they don't have to make those. They can play whatever choice they want to. And they have, those who choose those instruments are very proficient at it.
Can you, would you give me three names of people that had the greatest impact on your musical success?
I don't know.
Okay, then let me ask, who are your three favorite people to work with?
I never look at my musical success as someone who had a big impact, because first of all, and this is not being facetious, if you don't have talent, there's not very much they can do for you.
Amen.
You have to first have some talent.
Amen.
And now there is that, I call it technical talent, whereas if you sing off key, they can put you in key. But see, back in the day when I started, if you couldn't sing, as we used to call it, acapoco, if you couldn't sing a cappella and stay in key, then you weren't ready. But now if you have any kind of showmanship and can't sing in key, nobody will ever know it, because they put you in tune with a tuner. But I mean, there are people who I'd like to thank who gave me a leg up in ways that they allowed me to be a part of one of their shows. And one of them would be B.B. King. B.B. King invited me to do a show with him, and I never, you know, I did a recording with him. I shared an album with him, and I was in awe. You're talking about being in awe, because that's a man who I'd been listening to as a child. My dad plays his record every Saturday on weekends. My daddy would play B.B. King, Lightnin' Hopkins, John Lee Hooker, people like that. And here I am in the same studio performing with him. That, I would say, was an influence to me, because he was such a gentleman. Such a gentleman, always the gentleman.
Always.
And so I would feel that at some point in my life, in my career, being a part of one of his shows may have made people notice me a lot more. The other person I'd like to give a leg up to, who gave me a leg up in a sense, and I think a lot of the local musicians locally and nationally would have to say yes to that, would be Quint Davis. Because a lot of the local entertainers, before the Jazz and Heritage Festival started having these festivals, a lot of them were well-known, but not well-known nationally. Now they're known all over the world. And when people come from over the world to the Jazz and Heritage, they want to see the local people. So you'd have to give him credit for putting us out there in that venue to make us more well-known nationally. Other than that, I never thought about my career in terms of who gave me a leg up, because like I said, if you don't have the talent, ain't much they can do for you.
Right, exactly. Your friend that we all miss so much, Mr. Alan Toussaint.
Mm-hmm.
The collaborations with the two of you were just, I mean, there's anybody who thinks they know anything about you, Miss Irma, you know, is, oh yeah, she and Irma, I mean, she and Alan did so much together, so much together. That, like, y'all were, you know, you were not Sonny and Cher. You were not, you know, you were not duo. But
we were like brother and sister, because everybody hung out at Alan's house back in the day. I mean, when he was writing stuff for all the people he wrote songs for that was local, we were like the neighborhood kids, all hung out at his parents' house on Earhart Boulevard. So he got to know us from an entertainment level, and he got to know us from a friends in the neighborhood level. So he was able to customize songs for each one of us. And so it wasn't so much just him and I, but it was him and a bunch of other folk, like Benny Spellman, Ernie Cato, Willie Harper, to name a few. And so, it was a different kind of a relationship then. You know, I don't know if these kids know anything about split sessions, but you had to know what you were doing before you got to the studio, because it was a split session. It wasn't just you in the studio doing your record. It would be you and one other artist sharing the studio time. So he made sure we had our act together before we got to the studio, so it would save time. But we got to work together that way. I mean, they don't do it that way anymore, but that was the way we worked together. And we were just good friends. And we stayed friends up until, you know, until his time when he crossed over.
More often than not, did he just have a song that he had written and he thought, I'm gonna show this one, I'm gonna play this one for Irma? Or did he write songs and say, I wrote this one for you?
He would write songs and say, this is what you're gonna sing.
Okay. All right. I like that a lot.
And he did that with all of the entertainers that he wrote for. He didn't say, well, I'm going to write a song for you. He would write a song and say, okay, this is one for you. This is what you're going to sing. And he would literally tell you how you're going to sing it. Because we were all young. I mean, and he knew what he had in his head, how he wanted it to sound. And he knew that voice that he was writing it for would sound doing that particular note. So he gave us the song note for note. Now, once we learned it on our own, when we got on stage, we sung it the way we wanted to, which didn't vary very much from the way we recorded it.
Right.
Because I still do most of the songs that I recorded with him the same way I did it, with a few exceptions. I added a solo here and maybe another couple of notes at the end. But pretty much the way he did it for us, that's how we did it. But we were still new at it. So, of course, if he wanted the song to sound the way he hear it in his head, he taught it to us note for note. And we had no problem with that.
Do you ever get tired of singing certain songs?
No. The reason I don't get tired, because when I choose a song, I realize I got to live with it the rest of my life. So I don't choose something that I don't want to sing. And what makes it fresh each time I do it is that you're singing it to a different audience. Although in my case, most of the people that come to my shows, I've been seeing them most of my life.
Thanks.
But it's still mm-hmm. fresh, because it's a fresh situation. And each time you sing it, the people give you what you need. And then I'm one of those few artists who allow the audience to request. And 95% of the time, they request the same five or six songs over and over.
It's raining,
ruling my heart, don't mess with my man, uh-huh. Keep shaking mama, you know, cry on, stuff like that. And so I don't have a problem with that. They're paid to hear what they want to hear. When I want to sing what I want to sing, I can do that at home. But when I'm doing a performance, I want them to tell me what they want to hear, because they've spent their money, so they should hear what they want to hear. If it's anything you want to get disgusted, you spend $100 for a ticket and you go see somebody, they don't sing what you want them to hear. Mm-hmm. You know, they want to sing the new record that just came out. It's okay to introduce a new record, but them people done paid to come hear what they like that you have recorded. Sing that.
I love the way that you introduce new material.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I've always admired that. You sandwich it between those two that you've sung since you were 19. and Eric, you get to hear that one again. I interviewed you at the hospitality tent at Jazz Fest in 2019. Murph and I were sitting there. You had just recorded Even Now on and Walter Wolfman Washington's tune. Uh-huh. His CD had just come out, uh-huh. and you had not had a chance to hear it yet. Uh-uh. And that day we put headphones on you, and I sat across from you while you listened to that, smiled, the biggest smile I think I've ever seen you smile. And then you started singing it.
Uh-huh.
And I was just, that was an incredible moment for me. And I always wanted to ask you, how do you feel about hearing yourself? Do you have a hard time listening to yourself?
I'm my biggest critic.
And you should be, right, I guess?
There are songs that I've recorded in the studio, and then once I got to my live shows, I'm saying to myself, I should have sung that song like that. But oftentimes you don't have enough time to live with a song long enough to figure out other ways to perform it. So you do it the best way you know how at that time. But yes, I find times when I've sung songs and I've said, you know, I could have done this or that with that. But as long as people are happy with it and they're buying the record, I can always change it when I'm on stage.
When I talk about Irma, so many people will say, oh, she played my prom, or she played, I don't know if you went to CYO dances, mm-hmm, or whatever, you know, mm-hmm, the different dances, mm-hmm, or whatever. Mm-hmm. And I had a lady that sent a question, wanted to know if you remembered the dances in Biloxi, mm-hmm, in the late 60s.
Mm-hmm.
Where were your favorite places to play?
Anywhere they paid me.
I love it. This is why you are the queen, Miss Irma. This is why. This is true.
Anywhere that they're willing for us to perform or for me to perform, my band and I will play.
That's incredible.
We'll send them what we need them to provide us with. And we've done some shows where we've eaten more mosquitoes and flies and, you know, out there in the open. But we go wherever we're asked to play. We don't pick and choose, because you're in the business to perform. And wherever people want you to come and perform, within reason, we go.
You were raising small children, mm-hmm, when you first started.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't know how you started out by now, We're not covering that story.
There you go.
But you were raising. Google it. You were raising children, and what advice would you give to young females with families, and males with families too? Because we've got more dads, more involvement than used to.
Yeah.
But what advice would you give them to balance that career and motherhood or parenthood?
If you are blessed to have someone who can babysit for you while you're doing your performances, that's a good thing. But when you're not working and your kids ask you questions, find a way to answer the questions, because every day is not going to be bread and butter day. And it's not going to always be easy. So you want your children to understand that, yes, you're in show business. Yes, you are considered a star. But there are days when stars have hard times, too. So you have to let them know that this is a job. I go to work. And I want them to understand that it may look glamorous, but explain to your children that you are working. It's not always peaches and cream. And I think they will have a better understanding about life and not expect everything to be given to them.
Do you think we'll get one more album out of you anytime soon?
I have one that just came out on Nouvelle Records. Everything that goes around comes back around again. It's vinyl.
Yes, I apologize. I did see that one.
Did one of the songs tonight. In fact, I opened up with one. I did a remake of Our Day Will Come. Is a part of it.
And
so
you
yes,
put that one on that
I
one.
Just I just did it. Yeah.
I'm going back to the station and pulling out that
there bottle. You go.
I am so happy to be
thank
with
you.
And I hope that our paths will cross again very
it will.
Soon.
It will.
I would love to get you to do a tradition that we have here at the Funky Uncle, and it's not to sing me to sleep, I promise. we're gonna get you a Sharpie. Leo signed his. George signed his. You are not on here because you are. We're not dragging you down St. Charles on Mardi Gras Day yet, but most of our guys have a spot here. Would you write a little love note to Mr. Allen's on the side of the float for me?
Sure, I'll do a little quickie right quick.
All right, so, little quickie right quick, and then all we're going to get you off to where you are planning to go.
That's right.
Miss Irma, thank you so
My
much.
Pleasure.
Thank
My
you
pleasure.
So much. If you want to help us, please text FUNK to 36413 or go to thefunkyuncle.live and click on that donate button. These gentlemen are going to walk you over and make sure that you don't get tangled up in all of our foolishness. We have been so blessed to have Miss Irma here today, and I'm very, very excited to make this happen. All right, we'll get you to go around the can you go into that through that way or around the other side? Yes, Miss Irma Thomas, thank you again. Now we are gonna let you get on with your evening with your man, your husband, and your man. And we will see you next week. In the meantime, wash your hands, stomp your feet.